about sunrise? What about rain? What about all the things that you said we were to gain?
The direct correlation between rising carbon dioxide emissions and rising temperatures is shown here on the diagram. Rising temperatures are a danger globally as they cause rising sea levels as the Arctic Circle, Greenland ice fields and West Antarctica melts and disappears. This is especially dangerous for Bristol as a seaport due to more extreme weather variations over the seasons such as hurricanes, droughts and monsoons. Some scientists estimate oceans to rise 0.8 to 2 metres by 2100, enough to submerge many of the cities along the east coast of the US. Other predictions are dire, with a rise of 7 metres. Global warming is caused by the greenhouse effect of greenhouse gas emissions, which include water vapour, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide and CFCs. Most solar radiation that heads to Earth is either reflected out to space or absorbed by the Earth after passing through the atmosphere and therefore warming it. The greenhouse effect occurs when the solar radiation that passes through the atmosphere to the Earth reflects off the surface and instead of going back out to space, it's absorbed by the thicker atmosphere and re-emitted back to Earth, and so more solar radiation is absorbed. This causes the Earth to get warmer as we continue to emit more greenhouse gases. CFCs are organic compounds that contain carbon, chlorine and fluorine, which are used in products such as aerosols and air conditioning. They are bad for the environment as they destroy the ozone layer, allowing harmful UV rays into the atmosphere. CFCs were successfully reduced through the Montreal Protocol Agreement in 1997, where an international treaty was reached to reduce CFC emissions to protect the ozone layer. Carbon dioxide is arguably the biggest contributor to global warming out of all the greenhouse gases. This is mainly down to the fact that it remains in the atmosphere for a long time. It takes about a decade for methane to leave the atmosphere and a century for nitrous oxide, whereas approximately 20% of today's CO2 emissions will still be in the atmosphere 800 years from now. Carbon dioxide, as the chart shows, will be mainly emitted due to our vast dependence on fossil fuels to produce energy since the Industrial Revolution.
The benefits of greenhousing mainly come down to a more sustainable and efficient way of living, which has less environmental impact than regular houses. Greenhousing communities such as St. Werburgh's in Bristol use technology such as solar panels on roofs to provide additional power and heat water, as well as triple glazing in windows. Greenhousing can reduce heating and electricity bills to homeowners, making homes more efficient as less resources are used when heating and powering homes. Having green housing uses less energy and also reduces the negative externalities that are produced from electricity and energy production. Since most of electricity production in the UK is fossil fuel dependent, houses that require less power to run therefore require less fossil fuels being used up, meaning that there are less negative externalities, like less CO2 produced, which is thought to contribute to climate change. Nowadays, advances in technology and specialisation have meant that producing green technology such as solar panels and recyclable materials are cheaper than ever before. The idea that households can save money through green housing could give families an incentive to invest in green technology, as, in the long run, they'll be able to save money on bills such as gas, electricity and water.
In the current economic environmental climate, there is a pressing need for ethically constructed housing. Increasing population and reliance upon technology and power has led to increasing demand for energy. This increasing demand for energy not only increases the price of obtaining energy, but its effect on global warming through increased CO2 levels in the atmosphere is becoming a real cause for concern on our environment. The need for countries to encourage forms of greener living has become an issue of paramount importance. Green housing possesses a potential solution to this global issue. Green housing, or net zero housing, has the potential to not only benefit the environment from which we are so heavily dependent on, but also possesses the potential for the occupants of such a house to save money. There are environmental, ethical, health and economic benefits to this form of housing.
Why green technology will keep growing in the long term? As population are increasing exponentially and natural resources are depleting, substitution of natural resources is needed. So the innovation of green technology will be inevitable, which is environment friendly and save money. And what is the initiative for entrepreneurship in green technology? It's easy to get capital for share in the market because people see potential in green technology because it conserves environment and energy and is building a sustainability of future.